Niggas keep tagging me in this shit. This nigga Westside talking about I'm gonna be in the city. I need a director for the for a video. And my nigga is tagging me like no other. And mind you, nigga, I've always been tagged and shit. If, like, I don't know, Meek Mill say he needs some shit. I don't know, insert any random popping orders. Niggas always tagged me, but it was never to this degree. You know what I mean? So I said, let me just humor this a little bit, fuck around, see where it goes. I quoted his shit. You feel me? Quoted this shit saying, hey, yo. I forgot what the fuck I said after that. I said, hey, yo, something, something. I'm good for that. Yeah, man, whatever the fuck. And, yeah, that brought even more attention because it was already getting attention without me saying nothing, which just shows that I have more supporters than followers. Yeah, man. Followers, a lot of followers don't really matter if you don't got no supporters, nigga. You got just a bunch of motherfuckers watching and lingering. That don't mean shit. You just got a number to make you feel a little better that's right on top of your profile. But you got supporters that'll buy your shit, spread your shit, tag you and shit, make you feel loved, to listen to your shit, all that. It's a special thing. So, yeah, I did all that. I quoted this shit. Yada yada. I was retweeting the tags and shit, so more people were seeing it. Then nigga, I went to the studio, you know what I mean? Went to the studio, called my homies, linked up with them. Wasn't thinking about this shit no more. You feel me? Life was still going on. I didn't assume that was gonna happen, nigga. I thought, nigga, if it happened, that's cool, but you feel me? Like you could pick anyone. I don't know the other niggas that's trying to be the contenders, whatever the fuck. You feel me? Life kept going on. So I go to the studio, yada yada, make some ill shit, go back to the bed, yeah man. I fall asleep. I wake up. It's like 2-3 in the morning, yeah man. And I see a DM by this nigga Westside, like, nigga. Long story short, I guess it got through to him, yeah man. So that's how that shit happened, yeah man. And let it be known, I'm gonna say it right here. That nigga's a thorough nigga, through and throughout, you feel me? Had no problem paying me whatever the fuck, you know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? Anyone who thinks he not thorough when it comes to money, he one of the most genuine rap niggas out there, you know what I mean? Ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it. So shout out that nigga Westside, you feel me? Shout out Julia Lang, you know what I mean?
How did the actual video come together?
I mean, shit, nigga.
So he DM'd you. Was it like his, did he have an idea for the video or is he just let you get creative?
Some shit is blurry. Some shit is blurry because I've done so many things since then. I mean, that was fucking 2.5 years ago. Yeah, man. Yeah. But yeah, I just basically, he just gave me a time and where the fuck to be at. And you feel me?
Yeah.
I kind of did my, it was like a Revenant video, just a run and gun, do my shit. He didn't really give me no real instructions, which is my favorite. Yeah, man, so.
I feel like it's cool when people are real. Like, when people aren't weirdos and when people, like, pay you what you are worth.
Yeah.
They don't give you, like, if you aren't a director or, like, if I want to do art, like, if I want art, I'm not going to tell the artist what to do. Like, that's their job. You know what I mean? Why would I want to work with them if I don't want their input?
I mean, don't get me wrong. If you want a specific thing done for your project, ain't nothing wrong with that. I'll make your shit come to life, yeah, man.
Yeah.
That's my job. But at the same time, I'm good for those people that don't know what the fuck they want and they just want some ill shit. I'm definitely that nigga. Or niggas hit me up for last minute shits. So you know what I'm saying? They know I'll pull through for them. But yeah, that was the Julia Lay shit. It was a fun fucking shoot. Shit was in Quad Studios. Nigga, we shot in the same elevator Tupac got shot in. You even see the bullet hole in like a half second part of the video. Yeah, man. Julia Lang, she was a motherfucking empress. Knows multiple languages, a fly motherfucker. Holds her own, you feel me?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. She make a nigga look good, not the other way around. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. She don't need no nigga to make her look good. She'll make the niggas look good.
She a real boss.
Yeah, yeah. Shout out to her. Real respectable, diplomatic, all that. But yeah, she was cool. You feel me? Seen a couple of my homies there throughout the shit randomly. Met some new motherfuckers. Yeah. That was just about it. But the reception from when I dropped this shit, you know what I mean? Like, motherfuckers went stupid. Cause like I say, like people seen, like you see how all the people motherfucking tag me in this shit. So like triple the amount of people was even happy to see me doing this.
Yeah.
So I remember before that, I dropped a picture, you know what I mean, of him that I took of him in the studio. You know what I mean? Marvel was like, oh, so what happened? Yada yada. But then when I dropped the video, my nigga, niggas was stupid. Cause it was a hard video, you know what I mean? Wasn't just a regular average video that I did with one of my favorite rappers, you know what I mean? I made sure that shit was quality, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
That shit was clean. It was like, it was a combination of effects, but it wasn't too much effects. You feel me? I color corrected every scene different. Yeah, all that mumbo jumbo nerd talk shit. It was just crisp. It was everything it needed to be. You know what I mean? I don't even think he asked me to change that much shit. I don't think I changed anything from what I remember. I think how I gave it to him was what got uploaded. You know what I mean?